guys. So in this video, I will be discussing the subtraction of fractions. So in this case, we have a simple problem. So we will subtract 3 over 5 minus 5 over 10. So first thing to do is we should first find the LCD, or the least common denominator. So copy-paste lang po natin yung mga denominator nila. At gagawa po tayo ng parang arithmetic progression. 5 plus 5, 10. 10 plus 5, 15. And we have 10. 10 plus 10 is 20. 20 plus 10 is 30. So as you can see, the least common denominator nila, pinakamaliit na pagkakapareho ng denominator, ay 10. So gagamitin natin yung 10. And will be their new denominator. Hindi ko po siya didiretsyonin because para hindi po tayo malito. Okay? So what we will do, this new denominator of these fractions will be divided to the old denominator and multiply it by the numerator. So 10 divided by 5, ilagay ko lang po sa parenthesis, times 3. Then we have 10 divided by 10 times 5. Okay. So that would be 10 divided by 5 is 2, times 3 is 6. 10 divided by 10 is 1, times 5 is 5. So kocombine ko na po silang dalawa. 6 minus 5 is 1. So the answer would be 1 over 10. Ganun lang po siya. Okay, next is we have here another problem. As you can see, we have 2 mixed number or mixed fractions, and we will be subtracting these 2. So the first thing to do is convert the mixed number into an improper fraction. Ganun po yung first step niya talaga in solving a fraction related problem. Pag naka mixed number po siya, kailangan po natin i-convert muna papunta sa improper fractions. Okay? So mixed number. Sira na yung whiteboard ko. So improper fractions converted into improper fractions. Bibili ko ulit akong bago. So easy lang po yung pag-convert. So 10 over 8, first thing to do is copy the denominator. After copying it, we'll proceed in solving for the numerator. So what we will do is multiply lang po natin yung denominator and the whole number. After getting the answer, we will now add this to the numerator. Okay? Sulat ko lang po para hindi po tayo manito. So 10 times 8, lalagay ko lang po sa parenthesis, plus 1. So that would be 10 times 8, 80. 81 over 10. Same thing rin sa 6 over 3 over 5. So copy paste lang po yung denominator. Multiply. The answer will be added. So that would be 6 times 5 plus 3. 6 times 5 is 30, plus 3 is 33. 33 over 5. So this will be our new fraction. New fraction sets. Minus 33 over 5. Now, so second step is we should find the LCD. or the least common denominator. Yung gagawin lang po natin is parang arithmetic progression. Copy-paste lang po ng mga denominator nila. So 10, arithmetic progression, 10 plus 10 is 20. 20 plus 10 is 30. 30 plus 10, 40. Then we have 5. 5 plus 5 is 10. 10 plus 5 is 15. 15 plus 5 is 20. So as you can see, the least common or yung pinakamaliit na pagkakapareho nila is 10. So 10 yung gagamitin nating new denominator for this set of fractions. Hindi ko po siya dediretsuhin para hindi po tayo malito. So what we will do, we have now the new denominator. So this new denominator will be divided by the old one, and then we will multiply it by the numerator. So that would be 10 divided by 10. Ilalagay ko lang po siya sa parenthesis, times 81. Then we have 10 divided by 5 times 33. Okay, erase ko lang po para magkaroon po tayo ng space. Hanggang kailan asa? Isira na talaga yung whiteboard ko. Ang hindi na magandang tingnan. Okay. So, I will just rewrite it dito. So, 10 divided by 10 is 1. 1 times 81. 1 minus 10 divided by 5 is 2, 2 times 33 is 66. So iko-combine ko na po, 81 minus 66 is 15 over 10. As you can see, this is an improper fraction. So iko-convert ko naman po siya papunta sa mixed number. So, susulat ko lang po. Mix. Dito ko lang po lalagay. Separate ko lang po para yung time dito. Mixed number to improper fraction. So, i-divide lang po natin. 10 divided by 15. 1 times 10 is 10, subtract it, and this time hindi naman kaya kasi hindi na po kaya ma-divide yung 10 divided by 5. So we will be using this as our new numerator, and this will be our denominator. So that would be, the answer would be 1 over 5 over 10. Now guys, if maka-encounter kayo ng ganitong problem, as you can see, 5 and 10 has a commonality. Ano ba yun? Meron silang pagkakapareho. Both of this number can be divided by 5. So what we will do, we will divide both numerator and denominator by 5. Which will be magiging kuan up guys. 5 divided by 5 is 1. 10 divided by 5 is 2. So the answer will be 1 and 1 now. Tingnan po natin yung book. Number 8, 6, 7, 8, number 14. Answer is 1 and 1 now. Okay. So guys, huwag po tayong malito. Pag maka-encounter po tayo ng problem, and the answer is what is something like this, hindi pa po siya yung hindi pa po matuturing final answer ito, dahil yung fraction natin meron pa rin silang tinatawag na commonality. So once maka-encounter kayo niyan, so kung feeling nyo parang meron silang pagkakapareho, then you should divide it by the number that they have in common. Okay, for example, kung meron tayong pagganito, they say 3 over 9. These two number has commonality of what we will do, may dumaang motor. So what we will do, we will divide both sides by 3. Which will be given a, we'll have an answer of 1 over 3. Kahit i-divide nyo po ito, 3 divided by 9, so lalabas is, lalabas pong decimal. So, if you divide them into 1 over 3, lalabas yung decimal, magkapareho po yung answer nila. Magkapareho po silang dalawang ito. The only difference is, we converted this fraction into a much more lesser value. Pero mag-equal po silang dalawa. Okay? So, that's the end of our video. In the next video, I will be discussing the multiplication of fractions. So, please do, don't forget to comment down below, like, and subscribe. Thank you po. God bless.